In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create this fake 3D rotation rig. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel. It is controlled by just one slider control. And we don't use the Cinema 4D renderer, because it wouldn't allow us to use track mats, blending modes and other stuff we might need. Alright, I've already added a comp with a background solid and a diagonal gradient ramp. With no layer selected, we choose the rounded rectangle tool, then double click on it, which creates a new shape. Fill white, no stroke. Let's name the layer, of course, phone front. We open the rectangle path property, deselect constraint proportions and set the size to 540 and 800 pixels. The roundness to 40. Finally, we turn it into a 3D layer. Next, we duplicate the layer, Command or Control D, rename this layer Smartphone Frame. Hide the fill and use a white stroke instead. Width 3 pixels. Then we need to add some content to the screen. I've created a new comp, same dimensions than the shape. And I've added some simple shapes. We add the screen content to the main comp. Turn it into a 3D layer as well. And use the phone front shape as alpha track mat for the screen. Awesome, it cuts out the round corners and you can see the frame now. Next, let's add a reflection. With no layer selected, we grab the pen tool this time and draw a line. Diagonal across the phone screen. No fill. Let's set the stroke width to around 50 pixels. We name the layer Reflection. It's way too strong, so let's reduce the opacity of it to 50%. And let's do one more thing. We use a linear gradient as stroke. Both colors white, but let's reduce the opacity here on the left side to around 10%, on the right side to around 40%. Next, let's add two more lines next to it. We open the contents property and duplicate the shape inside the shape layer. Let's reduce the stroke width to around 30 pixels. Select the path, switch to the selection tool and position it next to the first line. Duplicate it one more time, position it. We want the reflection to be just on the screen. So we use the phone front layer as alpha track mat again. Awesome. Then let's add a light. We add a new solid, Command or Control Y is the shortcut. Let's name it light. Solid color, a bright yellow. We use the ellipse tool to add a round mask, roughly around the upper right corner of the phone. We open the mask property to add a mask feather. And reduce the opacity of the layer to 60%. Of course, we use the phone front layer as alpha track mat. This is the front view of the phone, with like no rotation at all. We'll turn this into a solid object with help from some standard effects. Another thing that is really helpful is my newsletter, which I recently started. It'll help you to improve as a motion designer. Link is in the description below, and there might be an exclusive freebie waiting for you. Let's build the rig first, before we add depth. So let's add an adjustment layer, name it Rotation Control, and turn it into a 3D layer. Next, we select all three 3D layers and link them to the Rotation Control. Now, if we rotate the adjustment layer, the whole phone rotates. But we want to control the Y rotation with a slider control. So we go to Layer, Expression Controls and add a slider control. Let's rename it Rotation. And link the Y rotation property to the slider control. The slider goes from 0 to 100, the Y rotation from 0 to 360 degrees. So we need to relate these different min and max values to each other. We do that by using a linear expression. First, we establish a variable. Y, like Y rotation, equals. Then we use the pick whip tool next to the property and link it to the slider control. Semicolon at the end. In the next line, linear and in parentheses, Y, 0, 100, the variable, the min and max value of the slider, which refer to the min and max degrees of the rotation, 120, 240, which is enough. So 0 is now 120 degrees, 100 is 240 degrees. Awesome. With this slider, we want to control the whole animation. including the reflection, which moves over the screen depending on the rotation. So we need to link the X position to the slider control. First, we separate the dimensions of the position property. Open the slider property of the adjustment layer in effects. Then we add an expression to the X position. X equals, use the pick whip tool next to the position property to link it to the slider property and add a semicolon at the end. We add a linear expression again, linear and in parentheses, x, 0, 100, let's say 750, 1500 pixels. So the reflection moves depending on the rotation of the phone, controlled by the slider control. I didn't make the lines long enough though, so let's move them down a tiny bit. Awesome! To move the light along, we simply link it to the reflection layer. Alright. What's missing is some depth, right? So let's duplicate the smartphone front, move it below and name it smartphone back. We make the layer visible and change the fill color to black. How do we position this shape? When the rotation is at 0, we need the shape to be somewhere to the left. At 100, it moves the opposite direction to the right, the distance depending on the rotation. At 50 in the middle, the shape has the same position than the front. No problem, we used this technique before. We need to separate the dimensions of the position property again. Open the slider property. Next, add an expression to the X position. X, like X position, equals, we link it to the slider control. Semicolon, then linear and in parentheses, x, 0, 100, then 1010, 910. So from its position at 960 pixels, the layer moves max 50 pixels to the left and right. Not bad. But it looks like two shapes with space in between. We want it to look like a solid object. I figured out a way to do that. Let's go to the beginning of the timeline, select the smartphone back layer, and first of all, we add directional blur. Set the direction to 90 degrees. Blur length to 50. You can see here that the blur fills the space between the two shapes. We just need to get rid of the soft corner. Therefore, we use matte choker. Geometric softness 1, 10, choke 1, minus 100, gray level softness 1, 55%, choke 2, 0, softness 0, iterations 1. Awesome, looking much better already. The edge looks still a bit rough though. To solve that, we add refine hard matte and set feather to 10. Awesome. Finally, we need to link the blur length to the slider control. We open the slider property. Add an expression to the blur length. Then we add L like length equals, we link to the slider control again. Add a semicolon. We again use a linear expression. Linear and in parentheses L, 0, 100, 50, minus 50. Let's check it out. The blur length is 50 here at 0. It goes back to 0 towards the middle. When the phone is looking directly to the camera, it should be minus 50 here at the other end, which doesn't happen. There aren't any negative length values, which wouldn't make sense. So we need to duplicate the effect and invert these two numbers to cover the other half of the rotation from 50 to 100 in the slider control. To get a reflection on the side of the phone, I used a linear gradient ramp for the phone back layer and added a white color point. Check out the free project file and better join my newsletter. Links are in the description. On the left side, I've added a video you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye guys.